prayers. We'd also like to acknowledge the presence of our dear sister Eileen Starks. Won't you just raise your hand, Eileen? Raise your hand. Thank God for her. She's been through the storm and the rain. But our amazing God has kept her for such a time as this. We'd also like to thank each of you from the onset that fasted all week long, laid on your faces and got on your knees in prayer and sought God. I tell you, God is in this house this morning. God is in you, and he honors your faithfulness. And there is a word from God this morning. Solicit your prayers. It's found in Mark chapter 2. We will be reading verse 12. Mark chapter 2, verse 12. Thank you, choir, for your powerful renditions. The anointing that rests on each and every one of your lives. We thank you. You are a gift in this house. Mark chapter 2. In verse 12, we also honor our musicians. They are gifts in this house. And we thank God for each of you. Mark 2 and 12, and it reads, and immediately he rose, took up the bed, and went forth before them all, insomuch that they were all amazed and glorified God, saying, we never saw it on this fashion. So the concentration this morning is on the portion of scripture found in verse 12 that simply says, we never saw it on this fashion. And our topic this morning is a new year, a new style. I got a new attitude. Lord, we thank you for the word that you seeded in our belly. We ask you to give us, Lord God, the grace, the power, and the anointing to bring it forth with conviction. Let it fall on the hearts, souls, the minds of your people. Let souls be saved. Let them be encouraged. Let them be healed, delivered, and set free. We'll forever give you praise, glory, and honor. In Jesus' name we pray, and the church said, amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Scripture reveals that Jesus began his public ministry in the city of Capernaum, preached about the kingdom of God, cast out devils, healed all kinds of diseases. Yes. Was in Capernaum where Jesus put his great healing power on public display. Capernaum is where Jesus Christ made his public claims to be the Messiah. But in spite of all of the rich salvation that Jesus offered the people, we read that the people of Capernaum were still in trouble. See, people, they valued the miracles that Jesus performed more than they valued the messages that he preached. Right. People wanted the supernatural. They wanted the spectacular, and they rejected the salvation. Thousands of people flocked to Jesus to see what miracles he would perform next. They didn't really want Jesus. They just wanted to be healed. They didn't really want to be holy. They just wanted to be blessed. In other words, my friends, the people just wanted to look good.
Come out.
Now, when we think about looking good, we often think in terms of fashion. Think of one sense of style. If we see someone who is dressed in mundane attire, or maybe their hair is not well groomed, maybe they wear the same clothing all of the time, we consider that person to be somewhat dowdy. We call them plain Jane. We say that they lack a sense of style.
Right.
Then there are other people who keep up with all of the latest fashion trends. Okay. They wear all of the latest hairstyles. They have the latest haircuts. And we consider them to be very stylish in their appearance.
Right.
Then there are also a group of people who push the boundaries of what is accepted as the norm in our culture. And they push the status quo, if you will. Their appearance and style is considered to be very avant-garde and cutting edge.
Yes.
Examples of this style may be Lady Gaga and her meat dresses, or Michael Jackson and his long wigs and his made-up face and white gloves. But regardless of where you fall on the fashion Richter scale, everyone has his or her own sense of style. And ultimately, everybody wants to look good. Now more than ever before, you see people are turning to cosmetic surgeries in order to enhance their look and to boost their self-esteem. Some people are trying to erase the lines of time, and they use Botox injections and facelifts to do it. Some people we find are displeased with their facial features. They're frustrated with their body structures. So they go and they obtain front and back implants. Some of them turn to nose reshaping surgeries, all in an attempt to look good. But my friend's wisdom teaches us that regardless of what your fashion style may be, regardless of what alterations you may have made to your body, your outward appearance is temporal.
Yes.
Because time will eventually leave its autograph on your face and on your body.
Yes.
And all one day, all flesh will cease to be.
Yes.
But your inside, your spirit being, your soul, if you will remain somewhere throughout eternity.
Yes.
Now, life and experience has also taught us that regardless of how much money we spend on cosmetics, regardless of how much money we spend on designer clothing, if you are sick in your body, none of these things are going to make you look good. You see, my friends, when a person is sick in their body, it shows from the inside out. Sickness, my friends, will rob you of your vigor. When you're sick, you don't feel like doing nothing. Sickness will strip away your strength. When you're sick, you don't even feel like putting on no makeup or even combing your hair. Sickness will rob you. It will absorb all of your time. Because when you are really sick, all of the things that you had on your agendas, they have to take a back seat, because sickness will hold you hostage to your bed. Yes, sickness has a way of changing the way that you look at yourself. Scripture reveals that Jesus was going around healing people with leprosy.
Yes.
He restored their skin to smooth conditions. Jesus healed blind people. He enabled them to see a world that they'd never seen before. The Bible says that Jesus caused those that couldn't walk to walk. They were able to go places that they could never have gone before. Can you imagine the sense of style and the new level of confidence that these people must have felt after Jesus had touched them? Oh, but above all of the miracles, Jesus needed the people to understand that their outward appearance was not nearly as important as the condition of their soul. Jesus wanted the people to understand that if they were not healed from the inside out, if their souls were not saved, they would never experience complete wholeness, and their miracles one day would fade away. And one day they would eventually die in their sin. So the Bible says that because the people would not receive salvation, the Bible says that Jesus stopped performing his miracles in Capernaum. And he left that area for a season. Somebody shout, Jesus, don't ever leave us. We're here for the right reason. Now, after some time had passed, we now read in Mark chapter 2 that eventually Jesus returned to Capernaum. And in our scripture text, Jesus is in Peter's house holding a revival. Jesus is preaching the word of God. And the crowds had gathered again for cosmetic surgery. The people had come to Jesus so that they could see what he would do next. The people had come so Jesus could make them look good. We can imagine in our spiritual imaginations that Peter's house was packed from the front door to the back. People jammed the doorways. I can imagine children sitting in the windows. Nobody could move. It was standing room only. Right in the middle of this service that Jesus was conducting, the Bible says that a man with palsy literally drops into the service. Yes. Now we must understand that palsy is a very debilitating condition. Right. It attacks the central nervous system. Right. When a person suffers from the palsy, their arms and their legs are often like noodles. They have no control over their body. Right. Scripture doesn't say if this man was a paraplegic, doesn't say if he was a quadriplegic, doesn't say if his injuries were caused by a spinal cord injury or rheumatoid arthritis or even a stroke. All we know is that this man was paralyzed. And that this man was in a state of helplessness. Scripture then reveals that there were four men who believed if they could get their paralyzed friend to Jesus, then Jesus would heal his body. By the time these four got their friends to Peter's house, it was so packed that they could not get their friend through the door. So the Bible says that these four friends, they carried their friend up the staircase and onto the roof of the house. They dig a hole big enough to get their friend and his bed down through. And they literally drop their friend into the presence of Jesus. And the Bible says that because of the faith of these four men, Jesus said to the sick with palsy, "Son, thy sins be forgiven thee." And then Jesus said, "Arise, take up your bed in this life.
Yes.
That's what makes us interesting. That's what gives us character. God made us all to be different. Yes. God had wanted us all to be the same. He would have made us carbon copies of one another.
Right.
But He didn't do that. Each one of us are uniquely different.
Yes.
No two people on the face of this earth are the same. Not even identical twins. I'm told identical twins even have different fingerprints. I don't know about you, but I'm glad that there are a variety of personalities in this church. I thank God that there are a variety of age groups in this church. I'm glad that all the women in this church don't look like me. Taking off. is tattooed from the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. Whether your hair is pink, purple, or yellow, whether your eyes, your lips, your tongue, your nose, and your navel are pierced. This is a new year. God wants you and your style to show the world the Jesus in you. Jesus said, tell my people that it's time to bring back my fashion. Christian integrity.